spaghetti squash pasta. The sauce is lemon, butter, and Parmesan, so it's super simple and it's super good for a fresh summer meal. If you want to make this vegan or vegetarian, you don't have to add the bacon, which we're going to top it with, or change the butter and Parmesan to vegan alternatives. So let's get started. I'm literally going to just mix it in a bowl and have it be ready because it's that simple, and I wanted it to be for summer, and I think the more simple in summer, the less you have to use your oven, the less you have to heat stuff up is great. So for this, for the spaghetti squash, I actually boiled it. I didn't roast it. It only takes about 14 to 15 minutes to boil the squash, so that's what I did. And it's super simple, so it's much easier also to remove the squash from the skin when it's boiled versus roasted, so that's why I really like it. I feel like it cooks the whole thing instead of kind of, I don't know, you know, it just works a lot better. And I just removed it from the skin, obviously, and it's sitting here, and I'm just gonna make one serving for myself. So I just pop some in here. It's once it's done boiling, I actually put it into a bowl and put cold water on it so it chills, so it's a lot easier to remove and doesn't, you don't burn your fingers doing it. So yeah, so this is about a serving to me. Then I just add a little bit of butter. You really don't need that much. Oh my gosh. So about that much butter to start. If you want more, totally can add it. And I just mix that up. It is room temperature butter. If you use cold butter, you are going to want to have your squash warmer because it needs to melt through the whole thing. And we'll just mix that in. That much either. You don't want it to overbear everything else. You just want it to mix well together. I have some pepper here. I love pepper, so I add a lot. Feel free to add as much as or not as much as you want. Add a little salt. Parmesan. Leave a little bit for the top just to make it pretty. I have my fresh cut cherry tomatoes. I just roughly chop them. They don't have to be perfect. We'll just pop those in here. Obviously, if you want to do a full scale like family meal with this, you just put it in a big bowl and mix all this stuff together. I'm not a big measurer. I think just put it in and taste it. If you need more or less of, well, do less of stuff first, and then if you need to add more, go with that. So be more conservative with the stuff at first and then add more. I have a little bit of bacon. I love bacon, but not too much of it. I think it can overpower a dish with its flavor. So just adding a little bit gives it the little like kick you want, but not too much in my opinion. So this is probably half of a, I don't know, half a piece of bacon. So then we have all those ingredients and I just mix it up into the squash. The reason I mix the butter in first is because I wanted to. There was no reason for it, if you guys were wondering. It can be a little difficult because sometimes these stick together, the squash pieces, so you really have to incorporate it and kind of fluff it around so everything gets into the squash. And I just try to separate it. That's why I like it cold too, because when it's hot, it really sticks together. Beautiful. You also could add like a little parsley or something in, on top for like a cute accent, but I'm not that fancy. So then I just kind of make it into a little cute pile. Oh my gosh, my dog, sorry. And then just add the remaining Parmesan on top, maybe a little more pepper, We have a beautiful, if you really wanted to, you could cut a couple more tomatoes up and just lay them on top. That'd be pretty. Or add a little more bacon on top, whatever you prefer. But yeah, that's the final product. And I'm just gonna taste it for you guys. It's so easy. Like, isn't that so easy? Literally took me like, I don't even know, a minute to do that. Oh my God. That is so good. In the description of below, I'll use all, leave all the ingredients I use, but it's so simple. I feel like anyone can really remember that. And yeah, let me know what you guys think of the recipe if you make it. Let me know if you add other things or what you do with it. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and see you next time. Thanks for watching.